In 1973, Iceland did something no country had ever dared to try. They poured seawater into a volcano. Sounds insane, right? But it wasn't fiction. It was survival. On February 6th, firefighters began an impossible mission, spraying seawater directly onto molten lava, 26 gallons every second, to stop a wall of fire from swallowing their town. The ground roared, steam exploded skyward, and the glowing rock hissed under the icy Atlantic water. Then, something extraordinary happened. The lava began to harden, its fiery red fading to dull gray. As the flow rate surged past 100 gallons per second, Iceland turned a desperate gamble into one of the boldest volcanic experiments in human history. A five-month war between fire and the sea. It all began quietly on January 21, 1973. Faint tremors rippled beneath Heimaey Island, just 4.6 miles off Iceland's southern coast. At first, no one thought much of it. The ground shook lightly, then went still. But by 3 a.m. the next morning, over 100 powerful tremors had hit. And just before 2 a.m. on January 23rd, the earth finally split open, less than a kilometer from the town of Vestmannaeyjar. A fiery fissure nearly a mile long erupted, hurling molten lava 500 feet into the night sky, painting it blood red. Within 2 days, those fountains built a 330-foot cinder cone. Lava crept north and east, slow, relentless, devouring roads, fields, and homes. By early May, the flow stood more than 100 feet thick and had swallowed nearly a third of the island. Heimaey wasn't some forgotten rock in the ocean. It was home to over 5,000 people and produced 3% of Iceland's entire economy through its fishing industry. Before that night, its volcano, Eldfell, had slept for nearly 6,000 years. No one believed it could wake again. But the eruption came terrifyingly close, stopping just 650 feet from the first houses. Fate, however, offered one small mercy. A strong west wind pushed the ash away from the city, giving residents enough time to escape. The same storm that had forced the fishing boats back into the harbor became their salvation. Within 6 hours, nearly every resident had made it to the mainland. Only one life was lost. The destruction was unimaginable. Rivers of lava and clouds of ash swallowed hundreds of buildings. Roofs collapsed under 16 feet of ash. Fiery bombs turned homes into blazing ruins. The city's power plant was gone. Fish factories had melted away. And Heimaey's harbor, the island's lifeline, was about to be sealed shut by lava. If that happened, the island's economy and its future would vanish overnight. So, the Icelanders made an unthinkable decision. They were going to fight a volcano. A few hundred volunteers stayed behind, shoveling ash off rooftops, boarding windows, and salvaging what they could. But soon, their mission changed. It wasn't just about saving homes anymore. It was about saving the harbor at any cost. The plan? Something the world had never seen before. Cool the raging lava with seawater. Previous attempts to control lava in Hawaii and Mount Etna had all failed, even on smaller eruptions. But Iceland had one crucial advantage. The ocean was right there. By mid-February, engineers had built a web of pumps and pipes to spray seawater directly onto the molten rock. At first, the lava slowed. Encouraged, they rushed in more powerful pumps from the mainland. But the lava front had become a massive, unstable wall. Too steep, too hot, too dangerous. Then came the dredging boat, Sane. Armed with high-pressure hoses, it blasted seawater straight from the harbor onto the glowing front. Steam roared into the sky, and for the first time, the lava stopped moving. It was working. More pumps were brought in. Soon, a maze of pipes sprawled across the smoking lava fields. Bulldozers crawled dangerously close to the molten flow, laying new lines on still hot rock. For the first time in history, humans weren't running from lava. They were controlling it. By March, 32 industrial pumps, each capable of blasting over 260 gallons per second, had arrived from the United States. Together, they unleashed millions of gallons every single day. Pipes cracked, melted, and burst, but the crews never stopped, welding replacements while standing on rock that still hissed with steam. Some even used plastic pipes filled with water, and against all odds, they held. 15 days and 132 million gallons later, the first solid barrier formed. The molten river hardened into a ridge, blocking its own path. Step by step, water and rock built a wall against destruction. The operation dragged on for 5 relentless months. Nearly 2 billion gallons of seawater were poured onto the lava, leaving behind 220,000 tons of salt crust as it evaporated. But in the end, the impossible happened. The lava stopped. Its own heat turned inward. The harbor, though narrower than before, was still alive. Against all odds, Iceland had fought a volcano and won. The eruption finally ended on July 10, 1973. By then, Eldfell had unleashed more than 8.8 billion cubic feet of lava and ash, enough to reshape the island itself. Heimaey grew by nearly 20%, its coastline permanently rewritten. Ironically, the new lava fields became a blessing, a natural breakwater that protected the harbor better than ever. By 1974, fishing companies were back in business. A year later, 85% of residents had returned home. The town was rebuilt right atop the cooled lava, with new roads, new houses, and geothermal wells drilled into still hot rock. From ruin, Heimaey was reborn. After the disaster, the people of Heimaey turned the volcano's fury into power. Literally, they tapped the leftover heat of the lava to warm homes and generate electricity, using the scorching rock that stayed hot for years. By 1974, the first home was connected to a lava-powered heating system. Nature had taken everything from them, then helped them rebuild. Even the ash and tephra found new purpose, paving runways, expanding the airport, and creating new land for housing. The eruption became a global sensation. News outlets covered it daily, and National Geographic called it the town that fought a volcano. The iconic image of firefighters hosing molten rock with seawater symbolized man versus nature, courage versus inevitability, and it worked. The entire operation cost just $1.4 million, a small price to save the town and its harbor. Compared to Iceland's other eruptions, Eldfell was small, but its story became legend. The people of Heimaey didn't run. They stayed, they fought, and they turned destruction into opportunity. Today, the volcano stands silent, though still active. Green moss creeps across the black rock, softening what was once chaos. Beneath it all, the people of Heimaey live with a reminder that survival isn't always about escaping nature. Sometimes it's about outsmarting it. If this story amazed you, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Share it with someone who loves epic survival stories and hit the bell so you never miss an incredible tale like this. You owe the people of Heimaey that much.